How the Earth Came to Be, a creation story. There was once a place that was rotten. It was a rotten realm filled with rotten creatures. They called themselves Shinigami. A Shinigami was a grim reaper, a god of death of sorts. They have many names, but their original was Shinigami. Each Shinigami has a name, but this tale focuses on that of one named Ryuk. He was a very bored Shinigami who wished for some amusement. However, there was nothing to entertain him in this terrible land. Even the apples had lost all their flavour. So Ryuk went to visit the Shinigami King, who had no personal name. He asked the being, "It's so boring here. Can you make something more interesting?" His eyes glinted. "Maybe we could have something living." But the king only shook his head in response. "Everything is dead, Ryuk. We can only kill, not make life. That is why we are Shinigami," he answered him. Ryuk sighed and wandered off, searching for something interesting. He then noticed a blue box seated on the dead ground. Its colour intrigued him, since he'd never seen something so interesting before. "Eh? What's this thing?" he questioned, even though the other Shinigami weren't around. "It's my TARDIS," a voice proclaimed, but Ryuk couldn't see the owner of the voice. "Who are you?" asked the Shinigami rather bluntly. The figure was revealed to be a man named the Doctor, who had travelled to the Shinigami realm in his time machine / spaceship. "I was bored," he said to Ryuk, "and I hadn't visited here before." Ryuk's senses tingled. Maybe this man would bring him the excitement he wanted. "Can you create something that's interesting?" he asked. The Doctor shook his head at the creature. "Sorry, that can't be done. I can't create life. You'll have to ask someone else." And with that, the mysterious man disappeared in his blue box as quickly as he had appeared. Ryuk was bored again and wished for something more interesting. There was nothing to do in this place, but he was sadly mistaken as another man appeared who was named the Master. The Master embraced Ryuk's plan to create life, and with a bit of a push, he made a reaction that made a planet. It was blue and green, and very interesting in Ryuk's eyes. The Shinigami King saw that a planet had been made and came to help Ryuk and the Master in their plans. They all grouped together and named this planet Kyojin. Kyojin was beautiful. Next in their plans, the Master created life on the planet and called them humans. However, he made a big mistake and made two different races of humans. One was about 1.5 meters tall, and the other race was about 7 meters, which was quite the difference. The group didn't know what to do about their colossal mistake and decided to try and kill one of the races by setting the large people on a rampage against the small people. However, the small people fought back, even though they were continuously devoured by the giants. The Shinigami King told them to scrap the planet and leave the humans to die out. The Master then created a new planet named Amestris, which looked a lot like Kyojin. This time, the human race was created at a height of 1.5 meters tall instead. Ryuk was disappointed with the people though, because they were all so boring. To make them more interesting, the Master gave them some of the human power called alchemy, which allowed them to create items from the bare resources. For example, they create a chair from a pile of wood. Ryuk loved seeing all these people with these powers, but something always went wrong. A few years after the creation of the world, one of the humans died, and one of the alchemists tried to bring that person back to life. But instead of bringing them back, the alchemist died, and left behind an artificial human, which the Shinigami King didn't like the look of. So decided to abandon that world as well, because he didn't want to deal with the puny humans who died. But they couldn't create a new world, since the Master had already left. The Shinigami King had been learning the Master's tricks, and decided to create a new world. The new world looked just like both Amestris and Kyojin. Then he created different looking creatures by messing up on his attempt at humans. He named these creatures as animals. Finally, after dozens of tries, he created humans, but to his dismay, instead of making mortal humans, he made them immortal. The only way he could think of stopping the humans from being immortal was to kill them. It was then he had a great idea. He could entertain Ryuk by letting him kill humans. The Shinigami King searched through different methods of killing and created a book named the Death Note, which would kill a person if their name was written in it. He created several copies of the book and convinced the Shinigami that they needed to kill humans if they were to continue living. To kill a human, they would write the human's name in their death note and extend their lifespan, even though they were immortal anyway. Ryuk loved the death note and visited the human world regularly to kill humans with heart attacks, illness, accidents, etc. The population of humans began to increase dramatically, and the Shinigami couldn't keep up with the population. The Shinigami King had to do something, and therefore he cried out, "Let there be light!" Before him appeared a human man whose name was Light. The Shinigami gave the young man a death note. Light began killing evil humans and never had a break. He made friends with Ryuk, and together they would entertain each other, ruling over the world. Light would often say that he was god of the world. Maybe they heard him, as they started to worship gods. They say that today, the Shinigami still kill humans to prevent them from realizing their immortality. Light continues to kill evil humans and punishes them for their bad deeds. Ryuk never got bored again and enjoyed watching the humans. "Humans are so interesting," is a phrase that you'll often hear. But you've ever heard who said it? It was Ryuk. So keep an eye out for that bored Shinigami before he takes your life. The end.